Imagine you need to go to the airport and it's the middle of the peak traffic. Usually it takes you 40 minutes to go for 20 kilometers. But what if you could take an air taxi and do the same distance within 15 minutes? Air taxis, the vision of Volocopter, urban air mobility, flying for everyone, was quite a big goal. Today we visit them and see how far they are with their ideas. I'm so excited, and maybe we can take a flight. Here we are. Hey Ying, how are you? So you're looking for the Volocopter and we've seen airplanes. Now that's our step into the future.
Yes, that's right.
Ying, you are fascinated about flying cars. So is traffic such as bad that we need air taxis?
Well, in Singapore, we are fortunate that the traffic problem is not as bad as some other cities in Asia. But the traffic can get bad, especially during the peak hours and when you want to go to popular areas.
So you can take the air taxi to drive to the Marina Bay Sands.
Yeah, so actually this is going to be our very first route. If I orientate you around the central area of Singapore, this is the Marina Bay Sands. This is a central business district, so this is where the Volocopter will be. So it's very accessible by buses, and there's an underground here.
But isn't that very loud?
We actually have 18 rotors. That means then that the sound signature is actually very low, and it will blend perfectly into the city noise that you wouldn't notice that it's even flying. So Volocopter has done over 1,500 times of real flight in cities
and
urban areas, and
that's,
even
that's
Singapore.
Real...
Yeah, that was, we did the test flight in Singapore back in 2019.
2019 already?
Yeah, so that's quite a while back, and it was a very successful flight. And actually nobody noticed there was an aircraft flying in the middle of the city. Yeah. That just shows how quiet it is.
And that's fully electric?
Yes, that's correct. All our family of aircraft have the common signatures. For example, they are fully electric.
So you are building a whole ecosystem of air taxis, battery exchanges, loading, charging. I've seen Volocopter several times here. Do you have one here inside?
Yes. All right. Do you want some?
Not true. I did not expect this one here. Uh-huh. I have to ask if I can go in. Can I have a closer look, please?
Yeah, of course. Yeah. Come on up. Let me show you closely. Perhaps I will undo the rotor now. As you can see, the first thing you notice is our redundancy system. All the flight critical component, we make sure we have enough redundancy, 3 times minimum redundancy, to make sure it's very safe. For example, the rotor, we have 18 rotors, and which are driven by 9 battery packs.
Where are the battery packs?
Let me show you. It's right back here. So as you know, our flight is fully electric. They are fully powered by rechargeable batteries. So these are the 9 battery pack. Let me show you. And we adopt a battery swap system. That means when you the aircraft lands.
Can I take one of those?
Yes.
How often can you recharge the batteries?
Probably about 1,000 times or
1,000
more.
Okay.
Yeah, to ensure that it's really used and maximum. And afterwards, we can always recycle and reuse the battery for other means. So this is a very important commitment we have for sustainability.
Can I have a seat, please?
Let's go.
Yeah. Wow, cool. I take off the bag.
Oh, you know where you can store your bag? Come. You
don't
actually
store the bag.
You don't need to leave the bag on the floor.
Okay.
And so we do have a luggage compartment right here. So why don't you leave your baggage there?
And
right.
It's in.
Yes, it's in.
On
mind your head.
I mind my head.
Yeah, mind your head. Yeah. And so this is how does it feel?
It feels good. So how to start this one?
So it's actually very roomy and spacious, isn't it? Yeah,
it's
you know, yeah, it's perfect for me. You know, my legs are not long, but even for you.
Even for me, I can put it here. So 1.90 meters
we could start now. You press the start button and we fly together to the Marina Bay Sands.
So this is the autonomous version.
Okay.
So actually this means that you know that there's no pilot on board.
When we start with the Volocopter, first the pilot will be on board and then it will fly totally autonomous.
Yes.
No one's checking this.
In the beginning, we're actually going to start with the piloted version because according to our market survey, majority of people will feel safer and the more at ease if they have a pilot on board that they can talk to, ask questions.
So we are ready to start and I could fly now to the airport.
Unfortunately, our first flight in Singapore will be a commercial flight over Marina Bay South area. So that's why we're not flying to airport yet, but we are working at it.
When will you start with the commercial flights?
We aim to launch our commercial services in Paris and Singapore by 2024. So it's not far away.
What's your opinion? Flying autonomously or having a pilot next to yourself?
Ooh, that's a tough question. I'd probably go with the piloted version first. How about your audience?
Let's ask them. What would you prefer, flying autonomously or maybe preferring a pilot? Write it in the comments.